Hey, what's up guys, Wally here. And yes, this is the machine learning course you've been waiting for. The updated machine learning specialization from Coursera co-founder, Andrew Ng. This is a three course series and a big step into revealing the fundamentals of machine learning and how to use its technique to build real world AI applications. Now, I've been taking this course for over a month now, and I can tell you it feels very different. So in this video, we're going to talk about my initial impressions, the course content, having taken the first part of the three course series, the skills you need to have before taking this course, the things I like, the things I didn't, who this course is for, and finally, is it worth the time and effort? Before we start, a big thank you to Coursera for sponsoring today's video. So without further ado, let's jump straight into it. My initial impression of this course was that it was going to be very difficult to learn. Machine learning being a tough concept to grasp required solid knowledge of data analysis, data science, alongside a bit of maths and coding knowledge. As a matter of fact, I had avoided taking any machine learning courses until now because I hadn't fully mastered coding generally, specifically Python. So I wasn't really sold on much of the machine learning course out there until Andrew Ng's updated machine learning course came along. Interestingly, this course did not disappoint in these areas. It's beginner friendly, it focuses on the fundamentals, and is taught by deeplearning.ai and Stanford Online. But I guess what really makes this course different is how this course was delivered, in the fact that Andrew Ng tries to give enough intuition behind the main concepts and ideas before introducing the maths behind it. Plus, being an updated version of a previously successful course, one that has been taken by over 5 million learners but taught in Octave, this updated machine learning course is taught in Python and on Jupyter Notebook. Now, this specialization only launched about a month ago and has three main courses. The first is Supervised Machine Learning, Regression and Classification, followed by Advanced Learning Algorithms, and finally, Unsupervised Learning, Recommenders and Reinforcement Learning. Now, in week one of Supervised Machine Learning, Regression and Classification course, you will be introduced to machine learning, starting with the application of machine learning itself, what machine learning is, supervised and unsupervised learning, linear regression, cost function, gradient descent, and learning rates. Now, these are the fundamental concepts in machine learning upon which all other concepts will be built on. In week two, you start to expand your knowledge of regression by learning regression with single and multiple input variables. And a good example that was used in explaining regression for both single input variables and multiple input variables is in predicting home prices. So, in predicting home prices, you will need information around the house sizes, numbers of floor, age of the house, lot sizes, and so on. And if the input variable is more than one, two other concepts become important, which are vectorization and feature scaling. This is where your knowledge of Python data structures and NumPy dot matrix multiplication come in handy. In week three, you learn another type of regression, which is the logistic regression, which is mostly used in classification. So you want to predict between two possible outcomes. The logistic regression is better suited than a linear regression. You'll also cover concepts like overfitting and regularization. Overfitting helps you to know if the model fits too perfectly and as such does not generalize well. And regularization is how you get the model to generalize and fit. In the second course, Advanced Learning Algorithm, which I only just started, an interesting aspect I look forward to is how I'll use TensorFlow framework to build a neural network with just a few lines of code. And I think that should be pretty dope. Another interesting part is learning how to code up your own neural network from scratch. Certainly, something interesting to look forward to. Now, in the third course, Unsupervised Learning, Recommenders and Reinforcement Learning, you'll learn how to use unsupervised learning techniques for unsupervised learning, including clustering and anomaly detection. You'll build a recommender system with a collaborative filtering approach and a content-based deep learning method. And finally, you build a deep reinforcement learning model. As with most people, you may find it difficult to get by this course without the requisite coding knowledge. So first of all, you'll need to understand Python programming, especially data structures and algorithm. Also, basic knowledge of NumPy and Matplotlib libraries, linear algebra, calculus, statistics, and some probability. But then what is nice is they did incorporate bits of beginner learning topics, beginner topics to bring you up to speed. So the most impressive one for me for sure is how the codes are written all out for you. And all you just need to do is to run them and view the outputs. They even went ahead to build interactivity into the charts and graphs. And these fun sliders let you control the view and the corresponding gradient descent for each point on the line. I think this is pretty sick. Now, you might choose not to run the codes out of the box, but instead rewrite them on your own Jupyter notebook and run them, which I kind of prefer. So how I do this is to split my screen into two equal halves and then have the course Jupyter notebook open in one half of the screen and have my own Jupyter notebook open in the other half. Then I gradually write out the codes afresh and run them. So if I need to import a library, I do that. And honestly, this is how anyone who wants to get the most out of this course should learn. What is worth, I use VS Code as my IDE and I have Conda running in the background. I imagine you run into situations where you break the code as you go along, but that is an interesting part of learning because it will strengthen your knowledge that way. So we've gone over things I like about this course. Let's talk about a few concerns that I have. One is the audio quality, which wasn't the greatest. I was expecting a much cleaner and better audio output from a flagship course. The audio had so much air in it, and I think it is better to use a headphone instead of using your laptop speaker. But also the fact that there is no signature capstone project at the end. So check out these three most popular, most enrolled data science certificate courses on Coursera: the IBM Data Science, the Google Analytics, and the Data Science by John Hopkins University. All have something in common. You guessed right, capstone projects. Now, they try to make up for this by incorporating projects into the course itself, making it more hands-on. So you get to build and train your machine learning models in the course. You get to build and train your neural network in the course and also build recommender systems still in the course. Not sure I prefer this approach of incorporating projects into the course itself rather than having a standalone capstone project. And that's because it gives little room for alternative solutions and we kind of have to go with the approach that was provided. But I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Let me know in the comments which one you prefer to have between incorporated projects in a course or a standalone capstone project. Now, will this updated course with its content and the way and manner it is delivered be as successful as the previous machine learning course? Well, that we'll have to wait and see, but already it has racked up over 30,000 enrollments in 1 month of launch. Plus, I think there are a lot of people who took the old course who are obviously not beginners who are now taking this updated version. And that is to say, this course is not just for beginners, but also for people at every level. So as long as you have some experience in data science or data analysis, and you want to scale to become a machine learning engineer, then this course is worth giving a shot. I guess the question we are left with at this point is it really worth your time and effort? And that's because the whole specialization is pretty intense and long. It does take around 30 hours to complete the first course and an estimated completion of 3 months for the entire specialization. So is it worth the commitment? Do you even need these skills? And I guess the answer really is machine learning is interesting to learn. I think if you value learning for fun, learning for knowledge, and learning to be better, then I think it is worth it. But you could also take this if you want to prepare for a future job prospect. Remember how a couple of weeks ago, news filtered that Amazon was recruiting software engineers in Nigeria. And what really came to my mind was that Amazon will capture those who have taken time to become prepared for such an opportunity. Right now, there aren't enough people out there who understand how to use tools like TensorFlow and build a neural network, build a recommender system, build a deep reinforced learning model. So if you can be one of those people, it does set you well apart. And that for me is a really good strategy. Anyway, that is for me today. I hope this was helpful. If you haven't done so already, do smash the like button if you found this content useful. And subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.